हेलो क्लास, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड. सो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम वंस अगेन टू योर कंप्यूटर क्लास. आई आंचल सिंह वेलकमिंग यू ऑल वंस अगेन टू योर कंप्यूटर क्लास. सो क्लास, इन द लास्ट सेशन एज यू ऑल नो दैट वी हैड डन और एक्चुअली वी हैव स्टार्टेड दैट हाउ वी कैन फॉर्मेट द टेक्स्ट. दे आर डिफरेंट मेथड्स थ्रू विच यू कैन फॉर्मेट द टेक्स्ट. सो इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैड डन दैट वी कैन फॉर्मेट द टेक्स्ट बाय changing it the font size. Okay, we can change the font style. Okay, so I'll just explain it. I'll just give you a quick recall, okay, of all the topic that we had done in the last top the last session, and after that we will continue with our topic. Okay, so in the last session we have discussed about that how we can format the text. Formatting the text means that to make changes, and why we make changes, the reason behind it, that we make changes so that we can make the document or the text more impressive, more attractive. Okay, in generally all the formal works, they are being done on the Word document only. Okay, so in the last session we had done that how we can change the type of the font. So if you want to change the type of a font, so first of all you have to do the selection. So just keep one thing in your mind, that whenever you want to change the style, size, or anything, if you want to make any kind of changes in a particular text or in a paragraph or anything, so first of all make sure that you all select that that text or that content. Okay, suppose you want to change the font size or sorry font style. Okay, so suppose I just want to change this one, it is written. Okay, so as you all can see on the screen, there's a story that is written about the thirsty crow. It is not a proper story. I have just taken a paragraph, okay, so that I can show you that how you can change the style of the text. Okay, so this is a story about the thirsty crow. Suppose I just want to change the first 4-5 words of this paragraph. So how we can change the font size or the font style? Okay, so first of all you need to select, okay, put your cursor on the initial point of this, on the initial letter, in front of the initial letter of the paragraph, and just make a click there, and then move the cursor. So whatever text you want to select, just move the cursor from there and that text will be selected. Okay, so now after doing this selection, you can change the size, you can change the style of the text. Okay, so from here, so here we are having the lots of ribbons are here, that is home, insert, page layout, references, and lots of tabs are there. So you have to select the home tab, click on home, okay, go to home, and then click on the font size that you, font style that you want to select. Okay, so click here as you all can see on the screen, and then make a click. So whatever type of or whatever type of font you want to change, you can change its style. Okay, so I'm selecting this one, that is Algerian. So after, as you all can see, after I have selected this one, the text which I have selected has changed into the another font that I have selected from the home tab. Okay, similarly, suppose you want to select or you want to change the size of particular text or something, so first of all just make sure that you select it. Okay, just select the text and increase and decrease its size. Okay, so whatever text you have selected, you can increase and decrease its size. So as you all can see, the text is increasing and decreasing in its size. Okay. So now I have selected this text. I want to increase its size. Okay, so just select whatever size you want suitable. So I'm selecting 36. Now as you all can see, the size of the text that I have selected has been changed. Okay, so this is how we can change the size. So first one we have done, that we can change the style of the text. Okay, and second one is that we can change the font size. After then we are having another one, that is the bold. Okay, how we can make the any particular text in bold letters. If you want to write some particular text in bold, how you can write it? Again, first of all, make the selection. Okay, suppose this you have already this the first sentence that we have written, that is in a spell of dry weather. Okay, so you want to change its, you want to make it bold, little bit bold, so that the students get attracted towards it. So first of all, again select the text. Okay, so as I am selecting here, okay, put the cursor on the before the initial letter and move the cursor. Then okay, click on home tab, as it is already there, the cursor is already there. Then select bold. So now I have selected bold, okay, B. Okay, the B stands for bold, and as you all can see, the text has been written in the bold letters. Okay, so this is how you can change the text into bold letter. Second, then after that bold button, the next one is the italic button. So how we can make italic? So what is italic? So first of all, understand that what is the meaning of italic. Italic means to write the particular word or the sentence or what the paragraph in the italic form. Italic form means the words are written in little bit tilted form. Okay, jo words hain wo thoda tilted form mein ho jate hain. So first of all, I have selected this one, okay, this sentence randomly, or sorry, these words randomly, and now I want to make it italic. So I have to click here, as you all can see here. So just click it and you all can see that this picture with a little water, sorry, picture with a little. So these words has been changed into the italic form. Okay. Next one is underline button. Okay. So next, if you want to change the underline, okay, if you want to underline something, suppose I want to underline the heading of the paragraph. So again, select the text. Okay. Click on the before the initial letter, click here, select it, and then click here, that is underlined. Okay, and as you all can see, the text has been underlined. Okay, so this is how we can make the changes. So this is all that we had done in the last session. Okay, this is known as formatting the text. Okay, now we will begin with the align left. Okay, so alignment. So what is the meaning of alignment? To shift the words accordingly that you want the text, that all the words or the sentences that should be start from the right hand side, left hand side, or from the middle part. Okay, when we write something handwritten, so whenever the teachers, they give you the question papers or answer sheets, so it is being said that make sure that you mark the lines on the both side, so that your text, whatever you have written, that should be in the middle. Okay, that should be in the middle of the page. Similarly, you can set the alignments here as well. Okay, so whatever text, okay, so okay, whatever alignment you want to change, you can. But the most important one is that you have to select the text. Okay, so whatever you text you want to shift on the okay oh, sorry whatever changes you want to make in the alignments of the text, you can easily make it. Okay, so select it again. I'm selecting this first paragraph here. Okay, now after this, go to this is alignment. Okay, so as you all can see, okay, when I have put my cursor here, so it is saying align text left, Ctrl+L. So if I want to shift the entire text to the left side, so it will be, actually this is already by default, it is on the left side. Okay, so let's move to another one. Okay, I'll center. So this is the center alignment. For that you can use the shortcut key, that is Ctrl+E, or either you can make a click here. So as you all can see, as I have made the click, so the text has been, the alignment has been changed to the mid. Okay, so this is known as changing the alignment. Next is another one. Okay, so where there are different options for the alignment here. Here we are having the different options in the alignment. Okay, next is setting the alignment of the text to the right. Okay, now as I've selected, all the text has been shifted to the right hand side. Next, okay, equal. So this is proper equal form. Okay, so there are four types of alignment: align left, alignment center, alignment right, and justify button. Justify, this fourth one is the justify. Okay, so first and the most important one is, as you move your cursor, wherever you are going to put your cursor, or the left, okay, so this is the, as you all can see, alignment text left, Ctrl+L. So Ctrl+L is the shortcut key for alignment of the setting the alignment to the left, whereas the second one is center. Okay, so so for the shortcut key for setting the alignment to the center is Ctrl+E, right? This is the, okay, the fourth, third one is ओके सो आफ्टर दिस अलाइनमेंट द नेक्स्ट वन इज नंबरिंग बटन. ओके सपोज आई हैव रिटन, ओके एज यू ऑल कैन सी आई हैव रिटन अ पैराग्राफ हियर, यू वॉन्ट टू गिव नंबरिंग. ओके सो सपोज आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू गिव नंबरिंग टू द कंप्लीट ऑल द लाइन्स. ओके सपोज दिस इज नॉट अ पैराग्राफ, दीज आर जस्ट सम सेंटेंसेज दैट आई हैव रिटन एंड आई वॉन्ट टू गिव सम नंबरिंग टू इट. ओके सो अगेन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल पुट योर कर्सर, सेलेक्ट द टेक्स्ट. ओके और यू कैन गिव नंबरिंग, ओके वेयर एवर यू वॉन्ट टू पिट. सो फॉर जस्ट मेक अ क्लिक हियर, ओके एंड गिव द नंबर. सो हियर फ्रॉम द, ओके सो ऑल दीज चेंजेस यू कैन मेक फ्रॉम द होम टैब ओनली. ओके नाउ यू कैन वॉन्ट टू गिव एनी काइंड ऑफ बुलेट्स और नंबरिंग. सो सेलेक्ट एनी वन ऑफ द बुलेट, वॉट एवर बुलेट्स यू विल सेलेक्ट दैट विल बी शोन हियर. ओके सो इसके बाद देखिए, वेन एवर यू विल मेक अ क्लिक एट द एंड, सो द नेक्स्ट. ओके सो दिस इज बेसिकली गिवन फॉर द बुलेट. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू शो सम, यू वॉन्ट टू शो दी सेंटेंस इन नंबर्स, अगर आपको अब जो सेंटेंस को नंबर में शो करना चाहते हैं, सो इन दैट केस यू कैन यूज दिस बुलेट्स. ओके सो यू इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मेक सम एक्सप्लेनेशन बाई यूजिंग सम इन सम पॉइंट्स, ओके यू वॉन्ट टू गिव सम पॉइंट्स, ओके सो यू वॉन्ट टू हाईलाइट दोज पॉइंट्स, सो यू कैन यूज बुलेट्स एंड नंबरिंग. सो ऑल दीज दैट यू ऑल कैन दैट यू आर सीइंग ऑन द स्क्रीन, दीज ऑल आर नोन एज बुलेट्स. ओके सो बेसिकली जनरली वी यूज ब्लैक डॉट और यू कैन यूज एनी बुलेट वॉट एवर यू वॉन्ट. ओके सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू पुट द बुलेट, ओके जस्ट मेक क्लिक ऑन द इनिशियल एंड प्रेस एंटर. एंड अब आप चाहते हो कि उसके बाद जितनी भी सेंटेंसेज जो अभी आप लिखे उसके बाद हर एक पे बुलेट्स आएँ, सो उस लाइन के एंड में यू कैन राइट. ओके सो ओके सपोज आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू राइट अ सेंटेंस आफ्टर दिस दैट देन एन आइडिया केम टू हिम. सो आई जस्ट वॉन्ट अनदर बुलेट, सो आई मेक अ क्लिक हेयर. सो एज यू ऑल कैन सी, ओके नाउ द बुलेट इज ऑलरेडी अपियरिंग ऑन द स्क्रीन. ओके सो दिस इज एन ऑटोमेटिक, वंस यू हैव सेलेक्टेड द बुलेट दैट विल स्टार्ट अपियरिंग ऑटोमेटिकली. ओके नेक्स्ट इज आफ्टर दिस बुलेट दैट इज हाईलाइटिंग कलर. ओके यू वॉन्ट टू हाईलाइट सम कलर, ओके यू वॉन्ट टू हाईलाइट द टेक्स्ट, ओके यू वॉन्ट टू हाईलाइट दिस पर्टिकुलर वर्ड और सेंटेंस, यू कैन जस्ट सेलेक्ट इट. ओके मेक द क्लिक, ओके यू कैन सेलेक्ट चूज योर कलर अप टू योर चॉइस. सो वॉट एवर कलर यू विल चूज दैट विल स्टार्ट अपेयरिंग देयर ओनली. नेक्स्ट इज ओके फॉन्ट कलर, दिस इज द चेंज ऑफ. ओके नेक्स्ट इज चेंजिंग केस. ओके दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वन, दैट हाउ वी कैन मेक चेंजेस इन द केस. सॉरी ओके सो वी कैन मेक चेंजेस इन द केस. ओके सो यू वॉन्ट दैट ऑल द वर्ड्स वॉट एवर यू आर रिटन हेयर यू वॉन्ट टू चेंज द केस. ओके सो इन दैट केस, ओके सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू सेलेक्ट. ओके सो आई हैव सेलेक्टेड द कम्प्लीट पैराग्राफ, फ्रॉम हेयर यू कैन चेंज द केस. सो एज यू कैन सी आई हैव पुट माई कर्सर हेयर. नाउ फ्रॉम क्लिक बाई क्लिकिंग हेयर यू कैन मेक द चेंजेस. ओके सेंटेंस यू कैन मेक द चेंजेस इन द केस. नो वॉट इज चेंज केस. ओके यू ओके सो दैट इज ओके सपोज यू हैव रिटन ऑल द वर्ड्स इन द कैपिटल लेटर्स बट यू वॉन्ट दैट एवरी थिंग शुड बी कुछ जो फर्स्ट लेटर दैट शुड बी कैपिटल इन द रेस्ट वन इज. सो दीज आर द केसेस. ओके यू कैन चेंज अकॉर्डिंगली. ओके सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई हैव सेलेक्टेड द टेक्स्ट, देन गो हेयर, क्लिक हेयर एंड सेंटेंस केस. ओके सो इन सेंटेंस, सो वेन वी राइट अ सेंटेंस वॉट हैपन्स. ओके सो वेन एवर वी राइट अ टेक्स्ट, सो वॉट हैपन्स, द फर्स्ट लेटर इज ऑलवेज इन कैपिटल एंड रेस्ट ऑफ स्मॉल. So this is how we can change the sentence. Okay, okay. Case similarly, lower case, okay, is there. Upper case is there. You want to write all the letters in the capital letter. Okay, the next one is capitalize each word. The first word of each sentence will be capital. Next is, and the rest are small. So first of each letter, not each word should will be capital and rest are small. The next is the toggle case. In the toggle case, the first letter of the sentence will be small and rest are in the capital letter. So this is known as changing case. Next is indent. Okay, so you want to give margins. Okay, so this is indent margin. So you want to give margin. So this is particularly used for margin. Okay, so as you call all again, this is left margin and this is right margin. Okay, as you can say, okay, now I'm moving this. Okay, so now jitna aap margin doge usi ke andar aapka text that will be written. So I'm decreasing its margin. The okay, so whatever margin I have given, that all text will be written in that only. Okay, so जो भी आप margin दोगे उसी के अंदर सारा text लिखा जाएगा. This is known as giving margins. Next is changing font of the text. ओके सो आई हैव एक्सप्लेन इट ऑलरेडी दैट वॉट आर द वेरियस. ओके नेक्स्ट वन इज इंसर्टिंग पिक्चर्स. ओके सपोज यू वॉन्ट टू इंसर्ट एनी पिक्चर. ओके सपोज यू वॉन्ट टू इंसर्ट एनी पिक्चर. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम इंक्रीजिंग इट्स मार्जिन सो द टेक्स्ट विल बी रिटन इन अ प्रॉपर वे. ओके सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू इंसर्ट अ पिक्चर आफ्टर दिस सेंटेंस. ओके आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू इंसर्ट अ पिक्चर आफ्टर दिस सेंटेंस. एज यू कैन सी माई इंसर्शन पॉइंट हेयर. ओके सो मैं यहाँ पे एक पिक्चर इंसर्ट करना चाहती हूँ. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई मेक अ क्लिक हेयर देन गो टू इंसर्ट क्लिक पिक्चर. ओके क्लिक ऑन पिक्चर देन सेलेक्ट द सोर्स थ्रू विच यू वॉन्ट टू एड द पिक्चर. सो आई एम सेलेक्टिंग पिक्चर्स. सो दे आर सैम्पल पिक्चर्स दैट आर बाई डिफॉल्ट इन एवरी लैपटॉप. So you can select any picture from here. So I'm selecting tulips, insert. Now, as you can see, sorry, this is not appearing. So there's some problem with the laptop, I think. Okay, so picture is already here, but we are not able to see it. Okay, so this is the picture. Okay, so I think this is not available due to some laptop issues, I think. Okay. So this is inserting picture. Okay, you can insert as many pictures as you want. If you want to insert more picture, go to insert app. Okay, click on picture, select the picture, insert. Another picture has been inserted. So this is how you can insert the pictures. Okay, we can even change the size of these pictures as well. Okay, how we can change its size? First of all, okay, so for that you have to go here. Okay. Move your cursor upward and downward. Okay, move your cursor upward and downward. So first of all, okay, you have to move your cursor and the picture. The picture will be resized. Okay, just a minute, wait, it is gone. Okay, I don't know why it is not appearing. So this is a picture. As you can see, as I'm increasing it and decreasing its size. So this is a picture that will appear. Due to laptop issue, I think it is not appearing due to some issues. Okay, so this is how you can insert picture and resize the pictures. Clear? The next one is wrapping text around the image. How we can wrap the text around the image? Okay, so what is the meaning of wrapping text around the image? It means that wrapping text means adjusting the text around the object or in images accordingly. Word provides many options to wrap the text around a graphic. Okay, you can write, okay, suppose this is a picture of a flower, as we all can see. So, okay, this is a picture of tulip. Okay, so I'm increasing its size. Okay, this is a picture of a flower, and here we are also having a picture which is not visible. So you want to write tulip below this picture. आप इस picture के नीचे tulip लिखना चाहते हो. So for that you have to, first of all you have to click on the object picture. Okay, this is tap text. Okay, so this is okay. You want to write in. Okay, so whatever method you want, देखिए. So now you want that all the text should be written in the square में हो, in the line with the text. So the pictures that you have selected, it will go like this. Okay. So this is known as wrapping the text. Okay. So जो भी आप pictures की position change करना चाहते हो, so that text. Okay. So you want that जो whatever you have written, that should be okay. That should be up below this picture. जो text आपने लिखा, that should be below this picture. So this I have selected. The picture is in the square form, and this is the picture, all the text, whatever is written, that is written below this picture. So this is known as wrapping the text around an image. Next was moving and resizing image or object. Okay, so that I have already told you. Okay, so you can resize the pictures accordingly. So you can increase and decrease its size. Not from this side. Okay, you can increase and decrease the size of your picture from any corner. Okay, from here or any corner. Okay, if you want to decrease its width, okay, you can change its width as well. Okay, you can move it left and right. So but okay, so wherever you want to take it. Okay, dekhiye the picture, that another picture that is okay, so we can, this is how we can move the pictures around. Okay, so you can give borders. So that I'll explain in the letter in the next session. Okay, so this is from my today's session class. So with this, I'm ending the session here only. So I'll see you again very soon in the next session. So till then, everybody, have a great day.